Sometimes life hands you lemons and then smashes them in your face. This is more or less what happened to my friends and I when we decided to take a day off from our field research to enter into a huge outrigger canoe race for the Hava Festival in French Polynesia. Unfortunately, at the very last minute, our team was forced to withdraw. We had expected to compete in this race that was going to be televised in front of a huge audience. Worked up the nerve to finally do it, and then it didn't happen. We were left feeling very unfulfilled. When all of a sudden opportunity knocks, one of our Tahitian friends suggests that as an alternative to the canoe race, we enter into the barefoot fruit stick race. We kind of laughed, actually, when we heard the name of this thing. It sounded a little silly. We thought, okay, cool, yeah, we'll do it. What is it? You run barefoot and you have a stick with fruit on it? Okay. That sounds funny. So we get all the materials that we need for this barefoot fruit carrying race. We cut our sticks that we're going to use to strap fruit to. But as the day unfolds, it becomes more and more clear that this race is actually not a joke. Shortly before the race, we learn that we're actually not just carrying a couple of bananas, we're carrying 50 pounds of fruit on these sticks. 50 pounds doesn't necessarily seem like too much though, so we're still feeling like it's not gonna be that crazy. When we finally get to the race, we realize very quickly that this is a very serious and competitive race. And there's a big audience, there's a master of ceremonies announcing the race. All the other racers are taking this very seriously. Many of them look like track stars and have been training for this for the whole year. This is where the intimidation sets in a little bit. We strip down into our Tahitian pareos. We're told at the registration booth that we are the first Americans to do this. They looked at us awfully skeptically. The race is 1.4 kilometers, so just under a mile, which seems perfectly reasonable.
This is a lot of men. I mean, compared to the number of girls.
Goodness gracious.
It's a lot of man flesh.
Yeah, all day. Look at our three dudes. They are so silly right now.
So we're all lined up at the starting line, and my competitive side is starting to come out. I actually remember very vividly turning to my buddy Chris and saying, I think I might be able to win this thing. I don't think any of us had any clue how challenging this was going to be until the race actually started.
Oh my god, okay.
Ready?
I hope he doesn't bust his freaking face. Holy cow, this thing, when you're in full running motion, is much harder to balance than I could have imagined. I actually almost lost my balance right when the race started. I'm running, I get out ahead of a number of people. Fatigue and quite a bit of pain start to set in. Not only are you running over rocks and dirt and you're cutting up your feet the whole time, but you have this heavy weight that's actually bruising you while you're running. After the first lap, I am feeling it. Meanwhile, Chris and Matt, the two other Americans, my friends that were racing with me, both of them had fruit stick malfunctions. Their fruits fell off their sticks, so they got disqualified when that happened. But being the competitive guys they are, they wanted to at least finish the race, so they picked up what they could and kept moving. I remember rounding the last corner before the final straightaway and thinking, I cannot humiliate myself by stopping. We made this huge spectacle. Everyone knows we're from the US. In the final stretch of the race, people, I think the audience that were all lining the raceway, I think they could sense my morale crumbling, and they started to chant Texas. This was an empowering thing, and I honestly think that that's the only reason I was able to finish the race in motion. Our determination actually got us in the newspaper. But more importantly, we earned the respect of the crowd, and we learned a really valuable lesson. When life hands you a fruit stick, it's not necessarily going to be an easy race.